Hi, this is Mato. Did you know that if your rating is under 2000, that studying tactics and middle games will help you to win more games than if you study just openings? The question is, what is the best chess middle game book? Would you like to know? The best chess middle game book is called Mastering Chess Middle Games by Panchenko. Let me show you the book. Let's start. This is the position from the game between Paul Morphy and Ernest Morphy. Let's evaluate this position. Who is better? Black is better materially. And if black manages to castle, he may even win. So white has no time to waste. How to prevent castling? How should white continue? What move would you play? White must play aggressively. And the most aggressive move is what? E5. Maybe. Let's see. So let's try E5. It looks like this is the move. It says by sacrificing a third pawn, Morphy prevents the black from castling. After D takes on E5, rook from F to E1, and after bishop to D7, rook from A to B1, black castled queenside, but now bishop to a6, and it says even if the king manages to run away, the attack continues, thanks to the great activity of the white pieces. The game continued with knight to a5, and now white played rook from e to c1, with a decisive attack, and you can go through the rest of the game at your own pace. Let's move to our next lesson. This is a game between William Steinitz and Shimon Vinava. The text says that black is behind in development, and Steinitz punishes him decisively for this. What move should you play? Try it. Perhaps queen to h5 comes to mind, but also f6. Let's try f6. Well, f6 is the move. And then you can go through the rest of the game at your own pace. But we'll move now to our next lesson. This is a game between Mikhail Chigorin and William Steinitz. And how do I evaluate this position? I am evaluating it this way. I am tempted to click on I don't know button, but that is a lazy way, isn't it? Have to think of something. What move should white play? If you don't know, you can click on I don't know, but I suggest we try to solve this puzzle. Well, I think I have seen this game, so I'm not going to pretend that I'm seeing this first time. This is a king hunting game. White sacrifice the knight on f7 for the king hunt, if my memory is not playing tricks on me. Sometimes it does. Okay, so let's try knight takes on f7. Let's see if this is correct. Knight takes on f7. True. The king is drawn into the center, where it comes under fire from the white pieces. The material factor takes second place. You can go through the rest of the game at your own pace and see how the game and the king hunt ended. Let's move to our next lesson. Next lesson. This is a game between Max Euwe and Salo Landau. It is white to move. Okay, the text says in this position white's e4 is hanging, and if you play e5, then knight to d5 would be played. And black has no problems. So how should white continue? If you have castled and your opponent didn't castle, then you should consider opening the files. So perhaps d5 comes to mind. Or maybe that is too ordinary. There is a crazy looking move. If bishop takes on a6, pawn takes on a6, queen takes on a6, check. you would have 2 pawns plus attack for your sacrificed piece. So should we try d5 or bishop takes on e6? Okay, let's try bishop takes on e6. This is not my game if it's wrong. Okay, what does it say? It says that this may not be absolutely the correct sacrifice. But this is kind of move that Mikhail Tal would also play. You can go through the rest of the game to see how the game ended. And let's move to our next lesson. This is a game between Mikhail Tal and Hans Hecht. Mikhail Tal sacrificed the queen to reach this position. What did he see in this position? How would you continue if you had white pieces? Quiz question is, what move should white play? Should white play rook to e1? No? Yes? Definitely maybe. I think I have seen this game before. Maybe on YouTube. Someone made a video. But I forgot what the move is. I think bishop to f5 was played. Wow, bishop to f5 is the move. And if queen takes on c4. First, if queen takes on f5, then knight to d6. Check wins the queen. And if queen takes on c4, then rook from f to e1 check. And after queen to e6, rook takes on e6, f takes on e6, bishop takes on g6, check, and white is winning. And you can go through the rest of the game at your own pace. Let's move to our next game. This is a game between Vadim Milov, Vistrus Majors. These names are a bit difficult to pronounce, aren't they? White's position is better, it says. The bishop on b7 is out of play, and the dark squares are weak, but he is a pawn down. If white waits, black will consolidate. White to move. How to continue? How to continue, and I have no idea. Actually, I have a brilliant idea, and that is clicking on I don't know button. Bishop can't go anywhere. Knight to c5, what is this doing? The bishop goes to c8, can white queen do something? What about rook to h1? Doesn't do anything. Looks like that e4 may be the most aggressive move here. F takes on e4, queen takes rook. If rook takes on e4, queen to b8 check, rook takes rook must be played first. If pawn takes on e4, then we activate the bishop on b3. Maybe. Hope e4 doesn't look silly. e4. Well, e4 is the move. It says white himself opens the position with his king in the center. This is quite a wild game, isn't it? After d takes on e4, bishop takes on f7, rook takes on f7, knight to e5, and after rook to g7, king e3. The king feels absolutely fine, it says. And white is threatening to win the queen. Wow. And you can go through the rest of the game at your own pace. That e4 looked very, very risky. It's a perfectly good move. Okay, let's move to our next lesson. This is a game between Aron Nimcovic and Zygmunt Tarasch. Black to move. I think I have seen this position before. This is a famous two bishop sacrifice, I think. So first is bishop takes on h2 check, king takes on h2, queen to h4 check, and after king goes to g1, then the second bishop is sacrificed, and king takes on g2, queen to g4 check, and then when king goes to h1, rook to d5, threatening rook to h5. Maybe. I think that's the one that I have seen in the King Hunt book. Is this the move? Let's have a look. And it says this is now the standard double bishop sacrifice. And how the game continued? The game continued. King takes bishop, queen to h4 check, king to g1, and then bishop takes on g2. Okay, I forgot. f3 was played in the game. I thought it was king takes on g2. So in the game was, it says that f3 was played. And you can go through this game at your own pace. As you can see, this is an awesome middle game book. You don't need chessboard, you don't need chess pieces. Everything is set for you to do your exercises and improve your middle game. Please click on the link below the video and get your book today. And that is all. I wish you good luck with your chess and bye for now.